Adding one more plane will make our game more interesting. In this lecture, I will create another plane class called plane2 by extending plane. By the end, you will be able to understand object-oriented programming concepts more clearly and be able to create a frame-by-frame animation like this. Open Android Studio. Right-click on the package and create a new class called plane2. Write plane in superclass. Press Alt and Enter on the red squiggly line and create the constructor. You need to find another set of plane frames for the new plane animation. Let me copy and paste my second set of plane frames in drawable folder. This class will have a separate bitmap array, hiding its superclasses implementation. So write in class level. Bitmap. Open close brackets. Plane equals to new bitmap. Put the array initialization code in constructor. Plane. Equals to bitmap factory dot decode resource context dot get resources comma r dot drawable dot plane2_1. Repeat the process till plane9. Since we are using a different bitmap plane array in this subclass, we need to overwrite all the methods where this array is being referenced. So, right-click inside plane2, generate, override methods, select all four methods and click OK. We should not use return statement like this, otherwise the base class's data will be returned. So just copy and paste the return statements from plane class. Let's implement the reset position method slightly differently. Plane x equals to minus open close parenthesis semicolon 200 plus random dot next int 1500. Plane y equals to random dot next int 400. Velocity equals to 5 plus random dot next int 21. In this case, velocity will vary between 5 and 25. Call reset position from constructor. Reset position. Now, animating this plane is just the same as the previous plane animation. If you can implement by your own, go ahead. Else, just follow along with me. Go to gameview.java. Declare a second array list called planes2 in class level, comma, planes2. Instantiate in constructor, planes2 equals to new array list. Inside constructor, inside for loop, create two plane2 objects and add to the new array list. plane2 equals to new plane2 context. planes2 dot add plane2. Next, in onDraw, inside for loop, write similar code for plane2. Canvas dot draw bitmap planes2 dot get I dot get bitmap comma planes2 dot get I dot planex comma planes2 dot get I dot plane y comma null. planes2 dot get I dot plane frame +++. If planes2 dot get I dot plane frame greater than 9, open close curly brace, planes2 dot get I dot plane frame equals to 0. planes2 dot get I dot plane x plus equals to planes2 dot get I dot velocity. If open close parenthesis planes2 dot get I dot plane x greater than open close parenthesis d width plus planes2 dot get I dot get with planes2 dot get I dot reset position. So basically, I used the same code that I used for the first plane animation. Nothing new in this part. The only difference is this bitmap array contains 10 elements. So we need to check whether the plane frame exceeds 9. Also, the direction of this animation is left to right. So we need to keep on incrementing plane x by velocity till it completely goes out of the right edge of the screen. Run the app. Awesome. So, to recap, I have shown you how to create a subclass of plane and override the methods. I have implemented this new plane animation with similar code that I used in the earlier animation. In the next lecture, I will draw a tank on canvas. I will also show you how to make your game full screen and keep the screen awake. See you then.